As you add more and more JavaScript to a page, you may notice a problem. Every function on a page is loaded into memory and therefore consumes resources. This can eventually cause the browser to become less responsive or even crash entirely. There are a few solutions to this, and one of them is the global script context. Normally, when you create a script object, everything inside that script lives in its own context in the web browser. Variables and functions declared in this page can access each other, but nothing else. Up in the TGML object, I have a tool to fix this. If I set use global scripts to true, now any variable declared without the var keyword will be accessible to every function on the page. Let me show you. In the TGML object, I'll create a new script. For the onDocumentLoad behavior, I'll create a new function called load. And in this function, I'll set a variable, say nominal voltage, to 480. Note the lack of var or let. This assigns the variable to the global context instead of the script context. Now I can create a new text object . Assign it a script as well, and give it an onMouseClick function. For example, inside this function, I'll just set the text content attribute to that nominal voltage. Over in the preview now, clicking on the text object will change its content to that variable. This is a very simple example, but think about situations where functions need to operate based on input from other functions. If you need to perform a very expensive operation, maybe you can do that once on page load, then read the value elsewhere. We can apply this same logic to functions. In JavaScript, functions are just variables themselves. Let me copy out the script that we created previously for our setPoint logic and paste it into the new global script. I'm still going to run this inside the onDocumentLoad behavior, but instead of declaring the function, I'll declare it as a variable. Effectively, I want to take the function's name and turn it into a variable name. So instead of function signal EVT, I want signal equals function EVT. That said, I want to give this a unique name because it's going to be available globally. Finally, I need to add a semicolon after the closing braces. We are declaring a variable, after all. Now for the script object. I can reuse the old rectangle with the snippet attached to it. I'll leave the script object's configuration as it was for now, but I need to edit the script's content. Now, instead of calling all this script text, I'm just going to pass my event object onto the global script. Calling that function object works just like the original function. Over in the preview, the rectangle works just as expected. While it may seem like we haven't accomplished anything, consider if we have dozens of these objects on a single page, or even hundreds. Remember that with the pan and zoom features, you may have an entire site on a single page. Also, you may build up helper functions for operations like conversions, user inputs, displays, and others. With all that in mind, you should be thinking about building libraries of scripts to store in the TGML's onload behavior. But there are methods to store scripts at an even higher level. Let's look into that next. Until then, thank you.